Thanks, Rohit, for that wonderful introduction. So probably I think we saw a lot of testimonials. Probably I will more focus on how the crossover happened for myself as such. I think Keerthi was mentioning about different categories of people, how they develop interest into social sector. I think I belong to the second part where developed interest about social sector during the course as such, in the past few years as such. So when I think my starting point was the last crossover session somebody was mentioning in 2017. It was exactly in June 2017, where I was one of the participants like you sitting over there. And then, of course, much before that, I was definitely interacting with Keerthi, and then had a brief idea about Youth for Seva and the social sector as such. But then the seriousness came when I attended this crossover session, and then started thinking about it, and then probably took about 6 months' time, and then joined Youth for Seva in February 2018. So what all happened back for me to take up such a decision, right? I think that is most important question probably many of you are having still in your mind. I think as Keerthi was mentioning, as a responsible family person for all of us, right, there are a couple of things which I also took into consideration. First thing is the children education, the children marriage, and their and also if you look at our own self health insurances or whatever. So these are 3-4 factors which I probably took into consideration when I said I'll have to change over to this sector. Then of course you may also ask about what about your lifestyle change as such. So being said that, that was also taken into consideration, and there was enough planning went behind it, and then there was no impact on the lifestyle change as well. And then probably some of you may also have a lot of passion towards maybe traveling around the world or whatever. Those are the things also which you should factor in when you kind of take a decision. So there's a lot of thinking and planning, and then probably to an extent I went one step ahead, because with all this I myself was not convinced enough. So I had to kind of talk to a financial expert who is one of my close friend as such, and then put in my portfolio in front of him, and then said, this is what I'm trying to do. Then he said, Bhaskar, you go ahead, you are at a low risk. It's not that you are not at risk, but you are at low risk. You can go ahead and take this plunge. So that's when I started as such. That's a brief about my financial planning I did. Of course, it's more of very, very individual based, individualistic based planning, which everyone of you agree in this room as such. So once I started here, right, of course, Keerthi and Venkateshmurthy, everyone told about the cultural change. I think, yes, that is true. There is definitely a cultural change. Probably I would slightly put it into one or two categories here. One is the heterogeneity of the projects. So what we call, I think probably we are all good in, or maybe experts in one domain. I take myself, I have been through last 25 years in telecom domain. So I can tell I am a telecom expert or a domain expert. So that thing does not work here. In the sense, the heterogeneity comes from different domains as such. So once we plunge into this sector, mainly you have to work. Of course, it depends on the organization where you join. As from Youth for Seva, we definitely have focus on 3-4 domains, which is education, health, environment, and differently abled. So if you look at these four are differently, again, vast domains on its own as such. If you look at education, there are n number of projects or n number of social issues which we may have to address. Similarly in health. So that heterogeneity is there. There is no way you can escape that. So you have to be kind of readily prepared for that, or get prepared once you join to handle these multiple domains. And second thing is heterogeneity of people as well. I think most of us sitting in this room, I know you have been probably in much senior roles. in your current role as such in your organization, probably you are very comfortable talking to your next level managers who are all definitely experienced managers. Probably when you talk to them, definitely the way you want to communicate or whatever, they will be able to understand. But the situation here is slightly different. I think you will be talking to people just coming out of the college, or even some people who would have not even studied college as well. Two different levels of people you will be talking, and then that heterogeneity makes a very, very key thing within the organization when handling the people. Then comes the second important part in my current role is corporate relations, which is again the major stakeholder is corporate. So again, I would probably say there is a much larger difference when you talk to corporates here as well. Of course, we have handled many projects, we talk to clients, and then there are different levels of engagements we would have had in our corporate experience. But here, the major thing, major difference what I saw is, again, the levels of people when you talk to corporates. Suppose one example is, when you talk to a corporate, we generally talk to a person who belongs to the CSR team of the corporate. And in most of the smaller companies, it need not be a CSR person. See, mostly these, generally a bigger organization like Dell, Cisco will have a dedicated team, and there would be a CSR head or a lead, or probably that person is an APAC head also. So, but he'll be handling all the CSR activities for the entire organization of APAC region. So from that level to a organization where they would have just started the CSR activities and they hired a person as a CSR manager who has just come out of an MSW course and he does not have any experience on the social sector. So these are the two, the lowest and the highest levels of people we need to interact. And then of course, the interaction levels are in such a way that it's more of going to them and then talking about YFS and then what we do, what kind of projects we do, and what are the different domains we work on. So many times the challenge becomes to convince them as such. See, probably people who have got that kind of a social sector experience, convincing becomes more easy. We have seen such people also. There are many CSR heads who have transitioned from NGOs to become a CSR head. That becomes more easy for us to talk to them, because at least we are in the same line of thought or whatever. But then when these two people, where some people would have, by virtue of their this one, he or she would have been a HR head, then just promoted to CSR head, and then they don't even know what are the ground realities. So those kind of people also, to talk to them, convince them, will become a much greater challenge for us. So these are certain things I would say from a day-to-day handling perspective, some of the challenges which we have to kind of slowly learn. Probably this is not something new for all of us, but then we will slowly learn once we are in this field. Then very briefly, I would talk about the kind of projects we work on. Because a lot of people, I think, focus more on rural projects and things like that. But then in YFS, of course, we have at least clearly in let us say one example, I'll take it as education field, where we have clearly focused our programs into 3-4 programs. One is more working towards a school adoption program, wherein we kind of adopt a school. This is more towards a project taken for a particular corporate, where they say that I have such and such a fund, so much of funds for from CSR. So I want to run a project, and then we will kind of probably give a proposal to them saying that we have so many list of schools where we can adopt, and then these are the programs where we can run in that program. So generally in that program, it is more of like it could be like setting up a computer lab or setting up a smart class, and then also working on some basic infrastructure facilities for the schools, and there may be some teachers workshop as well. And then also engaging those corporate, whoever is kind of adopting the school, making those volunteers to be part of some of the events in the schools. So these are certain activities when we talk about one single project like a school adoption. Or like that, there are many other projects like Lab on Wheels, where we talk about, we take up again a cluster of schools and then go to each of the schools and then teach them science experiments. So these are certain projects where we kind of work on as such in the education field. And similarly, there are a lot of projects which we run in Bangalore slums, as such, which we call it as after-school learning centers. Again, this particular project, again, we partner with another NGO where they are experts in this area, and then we work with them in a partnership mode. So these are some of the projects where we work on as such. So in a nutshell, probably I would make it very simple. I think we incorporates, I think many times in a day, probably who are all managers or at senior levels, two things we always keep doing in email communication. One is FII and FIA. These two we are very much familiar, right? Either you will forward something to your next levels or whatever as an information, or you will ask your next level to take some certain action. But then for me, transition to this has become FMI and FMA. It is for my information and for my action. So unless I get into the grassroots level and do certain things, things will not work here. So that is the only thing from my point of view, the crossover has kind of given that kind of education for me. And then if you have any questions, I'm ready to take it.